Hi everyone, it's me, Amber, and as I promised, I'm making the video to show everybody how to go into the settings and set up the accessibility features to use scanning and head movement on the iPad to access the iPad. No special apps are needed or external switches. I kind of stumbled upon this playing with my phone. As far as I know, you can do this with any iPod, iPad, or iPhone that is running the new OS 7 and has the forward-facing camera. So, here we go. As you can see, my iPad here, I'm going to go to Settings. And then when that opens up, I'm going to go to Accessibility. And then under physical and motor, go to switch control. And then you'll see right now it's set up for auto scanning. And right above here it says switches. Before you turn the switch control on, because it'll start, we're going to set up a switch. We're going to add a new switch. And then we want to use the camera as our switch source. Now you can also choose external, which would be like a blue if you want to use your another phone with your iPad. I could program my iPhone to work as an external switch for my iPad. You can use your screen, and that will allow you to touch or double tap, but we're gonna go to camera here, and you can either pick a left head movement or a right head movement. So I'm going to pick left head movement, and now it's asking you, what do you want when you move your head to the left, what do you want it to do? And so what I had done is I had chose for it to select the item for my left head movement. And then if you want to add another one and you choose camera and you select your right head movement, you could have it move to the next item. So what this is going to do is that if I move my head right, it's going to move to the next item. When I get to the one that I want and I move my head left, it's going to select it. So this would be like two switch scanning. So now that we have those set, I will also add that if I do this, if I do the screen, full screen, so if I touch the screen, I want it to stop scanning. And so you could do that so that if you're helping someone do this and you need them to stop, that you can just touch the screen and it's going to stop scanning without having to go in and do any other changes. So we're going to go back. So we have three switches here. We're going to, let's see, I'm trying to figure out if I had any other ones on really quick here. I am going to do speech on, and I do believe that this will also tell me every time it moves what it's on, so that if you have someone who's visually impaired and they can't actually see each of the apps or icons, they would be able to hear it instead. Okay. So I'm going to turn switch control on. And the switch control can also be turned on by triple clicking your home button. So,
can't tap, home, gestures, device, settings.
So right now, menu, tap, it's going through. Home, if you can see device, the blue settings, lines menu, on the edge tap, of my iPad, home, that is gestures, where it is picking device, up my settings, head movement.
Exit menu, tap, home, gestures,
and it's going really device, fast. So what settings, I'm going to do exit menu, tap, is I'm going to touch home, the screen. So I've just stopped the scanning. And now switch control is off. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the auto scanning time. And I did have to do this on my phone. I had forgot to do it. So and that's, as you can see, it was really, really fast. I'm going to set it We'll go 2.5 seconds for now. So that's the auto scanning time, so it will slow down a little bit. I'm going to, okay, instead of turning the switch control on here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to push my home button so you all see everything that I have right now. Push my home button, and I am holding my iPhone while I'm doing this, so kind of bear with me. I'm going to triple click on my home button so that the scanning will start, and you should see on the blue, on the edge over here will be blue lines. So if I move my head, you'll see those blue lines are picking it up. And once we get started, I will move my head out of the view of the camera, and you'll see a message come up as well. Okay, here we go. Maybe. Okay, sorry, that didn't work. It may not be set for this one. Let me just turn this on.
Cancel. Okay. Tap. Cancel. Tap. Home. Accessibility. Messages through camera. Facebook through notes.
So right now, it is just scanning Contact through.
iTunes Store through Google.
And it's telling me
Skype through FaceTime.
Skype through FaceTime.
Page 1 of 3.
So here I could...
Music through Safari. Music.
Okay, so I moved my head.
Mail. Tap.
So when I clicked on it, it's giving me the options. Do I want to tap it to open it? Do I want to go to the home button?
Gestures. Device. Settings. Exit menu. Mail.
So it says my face is too far away. I'm going to move up some.
App Store. Safari. Exit group. Music through Safari. Messages through camera. Facebook through notes. Contacts through video.
So right now I'm moving my head to the right.
Through Google. Skype through
and so it's going faster.
Page 1 of 3. Tap.
And right now I'm not moving at all.
Decrement.
I moved my head to the right. It went to the next one.
Increment.
Right move again.
Scroll.
Right move again. Left move. So it just said that it couldn't locate my face. So I'm going to move out of the view.
Messages through camera. Messages through camera.
And it says switch control cannot locate your face. So that did tell me then that I was not able to use my hand as a switch. It is using face, some kind of recognition in my face or my eyes. I don't know how, but so right now you see where it is. I'm going to do a right turn of my head.
Facebook through notes.
And it moved to the next one. Another one.
Contacts through videos.
It went to another right.
iTunes, Skype through FaceTime. Skype.
So I went to the left to click it.
CNN.
So now I'm going to do a left turn of my head.
Tap. Messages through camera. CNN. Advertisement.
So
sidebar menu.
So I hope that kind of gives everyone an idea, maybe something a little bit to play with, to try out for yourself. If you have any questions, post them, and then we'll kind of work on this together and see how we can make it even better. And I hope everybody has fun. Thanks.